In LUSAS version 21.1, pre-stress results can now be separated out, allowing you to see, for example, primary effects alone, secondary effects alone, results excluding pre-stress, and even effects for each individual pre-stress loss calculation. This model includes a full time-dependent staged construction analysis, taking account of creep and shrinkage, and therefore updating the pre-stress losses throughout the life of the structure. LUSAS can carry out these loss calculations to Eurocode, to Indian Roads Congress 112, to ASHTO, to CEB FIP 1990 model code, or the updated FIB 2010 code, and also to Chinese codes. From LUSAS version 21.1, in any analysis with tendon loads applied, a new settings call for pre-stress analysis options appears. Simply double-click it to choose which results you'd like to see separately. I'm going to choose to have primary and secondary effects of pre-stress separated out, and also results excluding pre-stress. Results for each individual pre-stress loss calculation provides a lot of extra results, so for clarity in this demonstration, I'm not going to examine them. Once you solve each load case, you can see separate results, which you can set active to see results graphically. I'm going to look here at the bending moment for each type at time 35 days. So here we can see the total effects, that's the dead loads and the pre-stress loads, including all losses. We can have a look at the results excluding pre-stress. Have a look at the primary effects of pre-stress. So that's basically your P times E, your pre-stress force times its eccentricity. And we can also look at the secondary effects, which is basically the total effects minus the results excluding pre-stress minus the primary effects. You can extract these results in any way you'd normally extract results from LUSAS. So diagrams, as I have here, print results wizard, reports, etc., etc. Even more importantly, you can put them into a combination. So what I'm going to do at time 35, I'm going to use the results excluding pre-stress with a suitable bed load factor, and also the secondary effects with a factor of, let's say, 1. The importance of this is that I've completely removed the primary effects from the applied load side. This is because generally, in most design codes, it is taken account of on the capacity or the resistance side of the calculations. Another useful function for pre-stress bridges, although not new in version 21.1, is to turn on contours of stress while the fleshed cross-section is being displayed. This can allow you to do a quick visual check for any areas of tension. If we look at the total effects here, take account of the primary effects of pre-stress, which should resist tension, and in our Layers tab, change our contour to be red or blue, showing compressional tension, we can see here that we do have some areas of tension in the top face of the deck over the piers. That suggests that maybe we need to change our pre-stress a little bit in this model. Separated components for pre-stressing, including primary and secondary effects, in LUSAS from version 21.1.